tired anyway.
Thanks, I am. It was a pretty speech, though. Wouldn't you care to hear it?
Oh, no.
It went, Sarah, dear, since we first grew up together...
12 years apart.
Well, I'll concede the point. Sarah, dear, since we first grew up... Well, I could cut that part out.
Oh, Horace, cut the whole thing out.
It's an irresistible speech. If you heard it, you'd fall right into my arms. It refers to the moon lyrically, artistically. A new...
Thanks for your kindness during the voyage.
Thank you. I hope you get along all right at Columbia. Goodbye.
It's the most comfortable place. Madame Donato always settles herself there.
Oh, Madame Donato, how is she? I must call her.
About the same, maybe a little fatter.
Yes, yes. Tommy met me at the boat.
Yes, he told me he was going to meet you.
Yes, he told me that he told you he would. Beautiful place.
Thank you. I just moved in.
Well, I was surprised you didn't leave Madame Donato's long ago.
I couldn't quite get up the courage. Besides, every time I even mentioned it, Madame Donato practically had a fit.
It sounds like her. Here you are.
Thank you. I don't know. He always said he'd never write a book. Tell me more about your beautiful blonde. What's her name?
Well, her name's Elaine. Elaine Martin.
Are you in love with her?
I wouldn't exactly call it a love match. We just like each other. Might work out.
What?
Happy when we've been together, of course, but that's not enough for a lifetime.
It's enough for me. Cigarette?
No, thanks. I've given them up.
Doesn't seem to be much left to say or much reason for my staying. I could almost be back in Innsbruck.
Do I look as bad as I feel?
You look all right considering.
Considering what?
Considering you wasn't in when I got in this morning. And that was 4:30.
What were you doing up till 4:30?
My gentleman friend said he'd marry me if he could get exempted.
What do you want to get married for anyway? Minute a man knows.
Sam.
Uh-huh.
I missed rehearsal again this morning.
Yeah, so I noticed.
Well, will you fix it up with McGonagall?
Don't I always? Daisy, at the risk of boring you, wouldn't it be simpler if I fixed it so there weren't any rehearsals ever?
It'd be pretty early in the morning for that, Sam.
The second lump is for the second cup, Miss Daisy.
Huh?
They only...
Just end up 20 cups. I get my sugar, but I have to order all the coffee in New York.
Seen the soldiers?
I heard it.
It's a terrifying hysteria. It makes even Jack the elevator boy want to go over it.
Just wants to impress the chambermaid with his uniform.
You'll be knitting socks with the rest of them before it's over.
What do those guys make?
$30 a month, I think. And, sugar.
Suckers. Now, there's nobody in that parade I'd want to knit socks for.
You're quite a little lady, aren't you?
You don't like the way I am? What are you hanging around for?
I don't...
Oh, please.
Same sort I smoke.
Well, that's the cheapest kind you can get. That's almost as if we told each other our life histories.
I think this place tells most of it anyway.
Have you been abroad long?
Over 2 months.
That's not long.
Right. Can you start tomorrow?
Yes.
We'll set up your board in the morning.
Looks like an interesting terrain you're walking.
Yes. All kinds of problems.
Hi, honey.
Oh, am I early?
No, just quitting. Oh, this is my wife, Miss...
Radner.
Miss Radner.
Hello.
Our new draftsman.
Oh?
Have you got a way of getting back to town?
Yes, thank you. The truck's waiting for me. You finished, Mrs. Scott?
Yes, thank you, Flora.
Would you like one of the kittens, Flora?
Goodness, child, what would I do with a kitten? I see enough of Horace.
Mother, why didn't Daddy come home for dinner tonight?
I don't know.
He knew you were home, didn't he?
Yes, he did. He said he'd be here. You know, it's way past...